Get ready to match the stars from Charlie's Angels, David Doyle, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from Dallas, Susan Horry, Gary Bernhardt, and Marshall Wallace, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rayburn.
How do you do? Hello there. Thank you for joining. How are you, John? Good, good. Everybody okay out there? Yeah. Splendid. Everybody okay up here? Oh, I don't think you're ready. I'll go out and start all over again.
Okay.
I guess I better put the sign up. Every once in a while, some little gnome plants a sign backstage there. This one says, just when I nearly had the answer, I forgot the question.
Why did you put that in front of Miss Brett? Any particular reason?
No, because I figured they would get a camera shot of it there.
See how she tries to make trouble?
I guess the world must note that Miss Marcia has a new hairdo.
Thank you. It's a new look. No more comedy girls.
See what that hairdo's done for you?
Drives him crazy.
Nice to have you back, my dear.
That's it.
Good.
That's it for the hairdo?
That's it.
Okay.
So fickle.
You have anything to say about the hairdo?
I think it's really adequate, don't you?
No, I think it's smashing. You look wonderful, Marcia.
Thank you,
we all love it. Now let's say hello to Barbara Gambini and Larry Herbert. How do you do?
Well,
let's get acquainted, Larry.
Well, I was born and raised in Los Angeles, and right now I'm a program assistant for a local radio station.
Really? You're a native Californian?
Yeah.
All right, Larry, good luck to you. Barbara, tell us about you.
Hi, I came out here from Deep River, El Segundo, Deep River, Connecticut, about 9 years
Yay!
Ago.
Yay! My state!
Deep River, Segundo. I live in El Segundo right now, and I work for a major airline in L.A.
All right. Okay, Barbara. That's it, huh? All right, good luck to both of you. Now we'll begin by asking Larry to choose A or B.
A.
You got it. Muggsy said our town is really tough.
How tough is this, baby?
At this year's church bazaar, we raffled off a blank. All right, Larry. Muggsy said our town is really tough. At this year's church bazaar, we raffled off a blank.
A gun.
A gun, all right. Someone donated a gun to the church for the bazaar, David. Do you understand?
They contributed a gun?
A gun.
How bizarre!
Yes!
Yes! Well, I was thinking more along the pugilistic side of life, and I said a brass knuckle.
A set of brass knuckles, all right.
Well, I think all of those would be at church bazaars. People would get an old gun, they'd find some cop would come in, give you an old pair of glass... brass knuckles. I can't even say ugly words. I didn't have anything here at all. No, I thought it was like really mean and hateful and tough. I said someone donated a small, very bright child.
We raffled off a small, bright child.
Now, doesn't that make sense if you're going to, in a tough sort of. Boy.
Put your braces back in.
Put your braces back in.
I wish I had said gun. I got very close. None.
A nun. Yes, what have you got?
Well, I thought maybe the church, they were trying to tell the pastor.
Uh-huh, you're through, Reverend. You've had it. Right. The town is really tough at this year's church bazaar. We raffled off
paganism. Human sacrifice.
A human?
Oh, heaven!
That's
good
a small,
for you.
Bright child.
I mean, that's tough, right?
No, that's real
right.
Good thinking
that's what we're
there.
We're trying to work to avoid.
Oh, really mine wasn't good thinking. What was mine if not a human sacrifice, mister?
Oh, God, she's turning on you.
That's right. What have
just
you
show
got?
Show you welcome, this haircut.
Okay, thank you so much. See, I think having some of that hair come off has made me a little lightheaded. So this might not be a fabulous answer.
Oh.
Organist.
The organist. We raffled off the church
raffled
organist.
Raffled off the church organist.
Wanted to get rid of him anyway.
Look, either boo or don't boo. None of this people booing out here.
Make up your mind. All right. Barbara, we'll have a question for you in a moment or so. Right now, friends, we have this for you. Ready?
Lloyd George knows my father. Father knows Lloyd George.
You don't know this one, do you?
No.
Waiter, check, please.
No time to leave.
In the middle of my song. All right, Barbara, we have this one for you. Sammy said, that sounds familiar to me.
It surely does.
Sounds familiar to you. Sammy said, this restaurant features a Billy Cotter sandwich. It's all blank.
What kind of sandwich? Billy Cotter sandwich? Oh, I got a Billy Cotter.
Sammy said this restaurant features a Billy Cotter sandwich. It's all blank.
The only thing that came to my mind was all bull.
All bull.
All bull.
Nope. All right, David.
Very good answer. I was staying along the brew line, and I came up with it's all foam.
All foam.
On the head of the beer.
That's right. He's famous for that. Yes.
That is a fabulous answer. There's no question about it. The girl is bright. She's smart. Not only is she attractive, she's intelligent. She's adorable. She's big. Boo, 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 boo.
All right, Charles.
I just said beer. I'm sorry.
Beer. It's all right. Don't apologize, Charles.
Well, he should apologize.
No, he
shouldn't
apologize.
He didn't think it through.
Billy Cotter, this features a restaurant, a Billy Cotter sandwich. It's all blank.
Well, I thought it was health food, so I said peanuts.
All peanuts. All right.
He is in a reconciliatory mood.
He is.
Reconciliatory mood. Peanuts.
Reconciliatory.
Forget it. I said, because I couldn't talk too well, I stuck with a one syllable answer. I said ham.
Ham. Yeah. It's all ham. Billy Cotter sandwich, all ham bone.
They're rough.
They are.
They're rough out there.
Yeah.
Hope they lighten up before the day's over. All baloney.
Baloney.
Oh, thank you. Well, maybe you're not too.
All right, let's go to round two. Barbara, you're ahead one to nothing. You go first.
I'll take A.
You got it. Ron said, my wife is the world's worst cook.
How worst is she?
You all flunked. English one, didn't you? One more time. And lay out.
To what degree?
Ron said, my wife is the world's worst cook. Even our garbage disposal has blank.
Thank you.
You don't like sweet.
Oh, shut. You don't like.
That's right. All right, Barbara, here we go. Ron said, my wife is the world's worst cook. Even our garbage disposal has blank.
Indigestion.
Indigestion. All right. She's been consistently good.
Yes, she certainly has.
Can we say the same for you?
You certainly may.
Oh, he's been consistently good.
Indigestion.
All right. Barbara, you're now at three.
Indigestion.
Wife is the world's worst cook, even the garbage disposal has.
Indigestion.
Indigestion. Thank you, Susan. All right, Gary Davey.
You want to see my John Wayne impersonation?
Yeah.
Heartburn.
All right.
God love you, hon. Don't give up your day job.
I haven't gotten it yet.
I know. Well,
this is my day job.
This is your day job?
Oh,
yes,
sure.
Oh.
Oh. What are you so sad?
Oh.
I wasn't invoking sympathy. If I was invoking sympathy, there would be much more sympathy.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah.
Marshall. And to that I say, acid indigestion.
Acid indigestion. Now, Larry, here's the way it is. You need five to tie and six to win. Here we go. Pete said.
Pete.
Pete. My wife has the figure of an 18-year-old. Unfortunately, it's the figure of an 18-year-old blank. Close enough. He said, my wife has a figure of an 18-year-old. Unfortunately, it's the figure of an 18-year-old blank.
Elephant.
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 Gave it his best shot, came up
I
with elephant.
I thought he said elevator, and I found that so zen, I blew my mind.
So zen?
An 18-year-old rhino.
Rhino. Close to an elephant, Larry. You're on the right track. Now I got to match everybody else.
I'm the villainess, correct?
Right.
I'm sorry, I said hippo.
Hippo! So that means Bartle wins the game. What do the rest of you have? Let me see. Elephant, hippo, buffalo, and boy. Come on down, Barbara. Please. Larry, we'll see you later for game number two, all right? Let's spin him off now and spin this wheel around, see how she's going to do here with the big super match where she could win over $10,000. Good luck to you. You're taller than I thought you were when you were sitting down. How tall are you? Stand back to back. Is she 5'8"? You have high heels on? Well, I'll have to wear my high heels so I can be taller than you. All right, Barbara, we polled a studio audience not too long ago and said write down your best answer to this. The four blanks. $500 for you if you match the answer they gave us most often. $250 for matching the second most popular. And $100 for you if you match the third. Now, whom do you call on for some assistance here?
Charles.
Oh. That's good, hon. What does it say?
What?
Very good. The Four Seasons.
There's one.
Brett.
Who?
You, Brett.
The Four Tops.
The Four Tops.
Susan.
The Four of Us.
The Four of Us. All right. So you have the Four of Us, the Four Tops, and the Four Seasons.
Four Seasons.
What? Four Seasons.
Yeah.
All right. David, what do you have?
I gave Four Seasons to Charlie.
No, you didn't.
He certainly didn't. I'm here to test.
He just gave you the spring. He gave me the summer.
No. You asked me what I had, right?
Yes.
I had it, and I gave it away.
Right.
The Four Aces, too.
Oh, that's good.
That's another one.
Very good.
I thought it was the Three Aces.
No, it's the Four Aces.
And then there's the Ames Brothers.
Or the four,
right.
What about the four plays?
The four plays?
No, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, David. Nice try, though.
I love it.
Let's see where it is, the Four Seasons. May we see the $100 response? Four Musketeer.
I like it, the Four Musketeer.
All right, let's take a look at the next one. The Four Tops.
There we go. There's mine.
The Four Tops. Well, they've got the S up there. They assume you'll put it on there. That's a singing group, right?
Yeah.
All right, here we go with the Four Seasons. Go.
Yeah!
You give David a kiss. He's the one who caught it up. All right, Barbara, you won $500, and we'll get to the rest of it in a moment or so, but right now we've got this for America. Here's Barbara. She's got her $500. That means the least she will play for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. However, we do ask her to spin the wheel and see if she can double it up and play for $10,000. So, Barbara, if you just step right up there, grab the peg and give it a pull, and we'll all root for a double here, and let's see if it happens. Gary.
It's going to be Gary.
Oh. Gary Berghoff for $5,000.
Two Connecticutites here.
Hey, right, two Connecticutites. It's a considerable sum of money. Good luck to you, and this is it. Twisted blank. Twisted Blank. You want to read it? Isn't this dramatic? All right. Now, to collect the $5,000, you have to come up with an answer that will match Gary. What do you say?
Twisted rope. I can't think of anything.
You couldn't think of anything. Gee, there was one that came to my mind immediately. What came to your mind, Gary?
You first.
Me? Well, I thought of Twisted Sense of Humor.
That's the one that came to my mind immediately, and then I changed it to ankle.
Yeah! Twisted ankle. So I have twisted rope, twisted ankle, twisted sense of humor. Yeah. All right. Now, Barbara, you've got the $500. You can play game number two. And so let's bring Gary or Larry back and start game number two here. Larry, welcome back.
Thank you.
Ready to carry on here?
Yeah.
She's got some money. She's got $5,000. That's not bad. You want A or B, Larry?
I'll try B this time.
B it is. All right. B says, Ralph said, my wife eats so many late night snacks. Our bed smells like a blank. Right. You got the idea, Susan?
Huh?
You're okay, Susan.
Jane, she copied mine, Uncle Jane.
She copied yours.
Doing it right now.
4 years now. Yeah.
Hey,
well,
what did you
occasionally
say?
They
don't
will.
You say think. Oh, I right, like that. I like David's.
You gonna steal David's now? All right, Larry. Ralph said, my wife eats so many late night snacks, our bed smells like a blank.
It smells like a garbage can.
Presumably, she left a lot of debris around, according to Larry.
They only change the bed every fortnight or so, you see. I thought it smelled more like a deli. Contestant.
A deli, yeah.
More like a deli. You see, first I said isoboxa, because I speak many tongues and that's Italian. Yeah. Then I thought, then David gave me sort of a glum look, and I looked over, and I said, so Charles's answer. Then I looked over, and I saw David's answer. It looked a lot better, so I said deli, too.
That's more information than I ever wanted about her answer.
That's true. I agree with that. A garbage can.
All right.
Uh-huh.
All right.
So, Larry, what this boils down to is, if Brett would learn to steal from the right person, you could do a lot better on this show.
True.
True. Uh-huh. Did you steal from anyone?
Brett.
You did? Oh, Jelly. All right. All right. What about you?
You can tell by my answer that I didn't steal from anyone. I said a cheese factory.
A cheese factory. Very original.
They really get vicious when they get in for nothing, don't
well,
they?
Well, yes.
There's something psychological about it.
Well, you know what happens here, Gary. They sit at home and watch this show, and occasionally they hear an audience boo, and they say, hey, what do you say we go down there to the match game and boo a little? So they came here to make boo-boo.
Right.
What do you got?
Well, what do you want?
Oh.
I said this, but didn't but copy. It came to me like a flash, a hot one. Deli. Ah.
Deli. All right.
There's no pleasing
them. Listen, don't
them.
Boo deli because it happens
booing
to be a good
life.
Answer. Now, when we come back from this commercial, I'll give you something to boo about. Get it out of your system, all right? Okay. 1-0 the score in the middle of round one. Now we got to stop do a little business with America.
That's got to be it. Right?
Well, now, we've come to the end of the road, friends.
Oh, no. Come here.
Yes, we've come to the end of the road. Dead end right here now. But you will return tomorrow.
Oh, thank goodness.
Good.
Maybe yes and maybe no.
Will you please return tomorrow, Charles?
I'll think it over. I might run out of outfit.
Or...
No, wear the same thing you're wearing today, and we'll be happy for that. Thank you all. Gene Rayburn here. Join us next time at the Match Game. Goodbye.
Some of our contestants will receive Hamilton's Jolene, silver dial with 10 genuine diamonds on the case. Bracelet is mesh and replaceable with adjustable lock from Hamilton. And beautiful sweepstakes carpeting from Galaxy Carpet Mills features Encalon nylon with Scotch Guard, Galaxy sweepstakes, and 10 contemporary colors. And have you noticed your nails lately? Buff them to a brilliant no-polish shine with Nail Buffs, the nail treatment for the whole family. Nail Buffs by Terrace of Springfield, Massachusetts. And Garanimals matching tag fashions. Children's wear famous for the quality, fit, and fashion that mothers insist on. Garanimals for boys and girls, infants to teens. And Simply Superior long-lasting glycerin soap. 12 exciting fragrances in different transparent colors. Gently moisturizes as it cleans. Simply Superior glycerin soap. Production. This program is edited for broadcast.